50 episodes on photographing Iceland, 3 years in the making. What a journey it has been. To celebrate the 50th episode, I'll start a mini-series in the series on photographing the Highlands.
This is like nothing I've ever seen before. It was exactly something like this I came for. This is just absolutely fantastic. I am now at Háifoss, and I was here first time back in 2016, and I had a fantastic sunset and a fantastic sunrise. And those photos are still some of my favorite photos and most popular photos on the social medias. This time I've come back. I want to focus more on the view from the downside. I have a very special photo in mind I'm pretty sure I can get today. And then I will, of course, fly the drone a little bit. It is fairly easy to get into Háifoss. It is recommended you get a 4x4, but a small car can do it. But you will get a very bumpy ride. So get a 4x4. Also, finding it, very easy. It's on the GPS, it's very known location, very well visited. So shouldn't be a problem finding it.
With its 122-meter drop, Háifoss is the fourth largest waterfall in Iceland. It can be photographed from many different angles, from an upper and a lower perspective. The upper perspective is easily reached from the parking lot. Just follow the trail down to the waterfall. Along the ridge, there are several different viewpoints. You can photograph it straight on and have the sunset right behind it around summer solstice, or you can photograph it with an angle and have the sunrise behind it also during the weeks around summer solstice. To get to the lower perspective, follow the trail along the ridge and down the slope. The trail is marked and easy to see. No matter if it's wet or dry, the dirt can be slippery, and especially when you are down in the gorge, you'll have to take extra care as the trail doesn't seem to be maintained. There are a few places where you will walk and climb on some loose stones, so getting to the lower perspective do require some effort to get to. Not to mention you will have to get all the way back up again. The part I struggled with the most were to find a proper foreground. There weren't much water in the streams coming from Háifoss and the neighboring waterfall Granny, so I had to explore quite a lot to find anything that made sense to put in the foreground. I eventually found a part of the stream coming from Granny that made some nice twirls in the water that could work as a foreground. It was a hard photo to get as I had to get very close to Háifoss and had to battle with all the spray coming from the waterfall.
So it's wet standing underneath a waterfall, I should tell you. It's fun being a landscape photographer. You get to do things you normally wouldn't do. Fun it is.
So
So what I find so interesting about the lower perspective here at Háifoss is how, as you can see, the ridge lines on both sides actually goes down in the frame. It looks as if Háifoss is coming down from atop of a mountain. And I think that makes this picture even more powerful. It's something I really like. It looks super cool.
I really wanted to get a photo from this perspective. In this case, I decided not to include an immediate foreground as I couldn't find any that made sense. As I've mentioned in several videos, don't try to force a foreground if it's not there. I really liked the sidelight on Háifoss and the rainbow was a nice addition to the scene. Sadly, I didn't really manage to use the rainbow optimally in any of the photos because of its location. On my way back out of the gorge, I found another spot with some potential. With a mix of a short long exposure for the foreground and a fast one for the waterfall to get all the details in the spray and myself in the scene for some scale, I ended up with another photo I really like. Back up at the upper perspective, I used my drone to get a photo I've pre-visualized since I was there 2.5 years ago. Because of the perspective, it is impossible to get from the ground and a drone is necessary. Thank goodness I have the Mavic 2 Pro with the 20 megapixel camera, because I had to crop this photo down to 1.67 megapixels to get the perspective I wanted.
So I am now in Gjáin, something like that. It's a beautiful little oasis, very close to Háifoss, down the F road. So you will need a 4x4 to get out here. There's even a sign saying that small cars are not allowed. So yeah, the 4x4 it is. So it's the first time I'm at this location and it looks just beautiful. Such a small little oasis in the Icelandic highlands. When I learned about it, I was quite surprised because it's not too long ago I learned about it. And it's really beautiful. It's really beautiful. Full of basalt rocks and lava cliffs and waterfalls, small bridges you can walk on, these flowery thingy something here in the background. They're dead now, but the entire place here must have looked even more beautiful when those flowers were blooming. This place is, I bet it looks really good during autumn too, because these leaves here in the background, they will turn red. Thank you.
Despite the beauty of this location, it was hard to find a composition I really liked. However, I did get this one from the drone that I think turned out quite nice.
So, good morning from this mildly unimpressive sunrise. Probably possible to get something out of it, but it is freaking cold. Well, it feels cold. I actually don't think it's that cold, but the wind chill is huge. So, I'm here at this beautiful waterfall, and it is just perfectly situated underneath this mountain here in the background. And I'm playing around with the foreground. I have tried a few different along the ridge here. I think this is my favorite. And then I will probably crop it to a square format because there's a little bit too much foreground and a bit too much sky in the photo. If I walk over here, I can get a pretty decent horizontal photo. And I will go get those two. But right now I'm basically just battling the cold and the wind.
Despite the short distance between Háifoss and Búrfell, you might consider not visiting them straight after each other. The shortest road between these locations are absolutely horrible to drive on. The yellow part on this map is a very bad and very bumpy gravel road. The sky I had this morning was clear, so I had to focus most of the photos on the mountain and the waterfall. That's arguably also what you want to do, as you don't want the sky to be too distracting. I know a lot of you will have several questions in regard to photographing and traveling in the highlands. Just leave your question down in the description and I'll answer them in a later episode. If you want to go to Iceland on your own, be sure to get my digital map with all the amazing photography locations I've visited in my videos. The map is easy to use with Google Maps. So that was all for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. And in the next episode, I'll go to a location I've wanted to visit for many years.